So I would like to thank Michele for giving me the opportunity to tell you about this project I've been working on. As you may hear, I'm a little sick, so I hope you will understand me just well. This project aims to create a digital tool to visualize the links between philosophical texts, in particular the explicit and implicit references that a philosophical work can make to previous works. It will also allow to identify within these references the agreement or disagreement of the text with the text to which it refers. It's a crowdsourcing and collaborative project, so I will be working with teachers and researchers specializing in an author or a work to identify new references in the different texts, and any contributor will be able to open a discussion or comment references or debate about it in a case of disagreement on the link between two texts. The project is still a work in progress, and it is at its very beginning. I just applied last month for a grant for the development of the proof of concept, and I will know in March if the grant has been accepted. I'm currently a PhD student in criminal law, but I also work on another project named Knowledge Tree that tries to create a graph representation of the mentorship in science. And you can see the website of the project at the link I put in the slide. And I'm also greatly interested in philosophy and especially in the work of Wittgenstein. And that's how I had the idea to work on this project. So the project is named The Great Conversation and aims to create two distinct representations of the references between philosophical works. The first representation will be a directed graph mapping the relations between philosophical works. The graph will be based on scholarly sources about such relation between two texts. Each relation should be justified so that any reader can know why a researcher thinks a text refers to another. There will be a system of filter so that anyone will be allowed to display different aspects of the graph. For example, you could choose to display the relations along a chronological axis, or you could choose to see only the relations between texts in moral philosophy. The second representation will be a hyperlinked version of philosophical works with footnotes. This representation will look like any paper book, but the footnotes will contain links on which the reader can click to check the external references made by the author. A pop-up will open, as you can see in the visual in the slide, with the quotation of the text to which the author is referring. And the reader will then be able to open the hyperlinked version of the book which the author has made a reference to. And in the example, you can see in the slide, the reader will see a quotation of Hume, and then will be able to go to the old text of the Treatise of Human Nature at the place where the quotation can be found. The proof of concept of the project will be based on the philosophical investigations by Wittgenstein. If the grant is accepted, the development team will work on the website from March to October. Then we will take 1 year and a half to work on the proof of concept around the philosophical investigations. The partners already gave me some sources to begin to work on the graph, but we will have to find other sources as well. And our goal is to achieve a hyperlink version of the philosophical investigation and discuss most explicit and implicit references in this work, as well as defined the criteria on which researchers base their choice to establish a relation between two texts. And we also aim to refine the interface of the website so that researchers can use it very easily to add new philosophical texts on the website and work on the relations between these texts and other works. And you can see on the right of the slide the interface on which a researcher will create a new reference and justify his choice. And if you're interested in this project and want to help us, you can contact me at this email address. And we'd appreciate any kind of help. For example, you may want to work on the references around the work of another author or around another text of Wittgenstein. You can also send us sources in which you think an author talk about implicit references in philosophical investigations, or let us know if you yourself think you know about implicit references in Wittgenstein. And you can also just let me know if you have any suggestion about the realization of the website. Yeah, thank you very much.